गुजरात विधानसभा निवडणुकीची तारीख आता काही क्षणात जाहीर होणार आहे. गुजरातमध्ये डिसेंबर महिन्यात दोन टप्प्यात निवडणूक घेतली जाईल असं सूत्रांचं म्हणणं आहे. तर येत्या 18 डिसेंबरला
All the media friends present here and the senior officers of commission present here and all the media persons present here near election commissioner Shri Rawat, election commissioner Shri Arora, all the senior officials of the election commission and the media friends present here. Today we are with you to announce the schedule of election for Gujarat Assembly. The term of Gujarat Assembly is likely to expire on 22nd January 2018. The total number of assembly seats are 182. As far as electoral roll is concerned, that is a basic document. The health of the electoral roll is very important. A very rigorous and a sincere electoral roll upgradation exercise was taken, and the total number of electors as per the final roll of the electoral roll, which is published on 25th September 2017, the number is 4.33 crores. As far as electoral roll is concerned, a special drive to enroll all the left out voters was organized from 9th to 25th October, in which the BLOs have been asked to visit the houses of every family in the area, and if they will further collect the forms if some people have been left out. Photo electoral rolls are also updated, and the percentage is 99.99%. The photo voter slips before the date of polling, all the voters would be given a voter slip bearing the photo of the elector, and it will be distributed at least 7 days before the date of poll to all the enrolled members by the BLOs. This time we have also asked the CO Gujarat and CO Himachal Pradesh that voter guide brochure should also be issued in the local language, so that the voter and the family members know where they have to go for voting. The voter guide brochure will be distributed along with the photo voter slips by the BLOs. The total number of polling stations now is 50,128, and the number of polling stations in the 2012 election was 44,579. So there is an increase of 12.44%. This time, when the exercise of rationalization of polling station was undertaken, we had asked all the DOs and the CO that he should ensure that in the urban pockets the number of voters should be 1400, and in the case of rural areas it should be 1200. Coming to the assured minimum facilities which the state government authorities have to provide at the polling stations, I am happy to state that the state government has made good efforts to provide assured minimum facilities at all these polling stations. The percentage as reported to us is that all the polling stations will have ramp, that is 100%. Electricity provision is also 100%. Drinking water facilities also 100%. Stations with toilet facilities 100%. And polling station not on ground floor is also 100%. And the polling station with waiting room shared is 99.9%. As far as the facilitation for person with disabilities is concerned, we had asked the Goa Gujarat CO, because the beginning was made by Goa CO that in the February poll 2017, he had prepared a database for all the persons with disabilities. On the same lines, we had asked CO Gujarat, and he has done a very good work along with their DOs, and all a database has been prepared, and all the persons with physical disability voters now have been identified, and what type of help is required has also been identified, and the polling necessary disability specific arrangements have been made for their smooth and convenient voting experience on the polling day. Identified PWDs would be assisted by volunteers appointed by the ROs, the DOs. A special facilitation will be made for PWD electors at the polling station. It has also been directed that differently abled electors be given priority for entering the polling booths. Provisions have been made for designated parking space close to the entrance of these. Special focus has been laid for sensitization of polling personnel regarding the needs of these differently abled persons. Another feature which has been added is to provide voter assistance booth. The voter assistance booth will be set up for every polling station location, where a team of BLO and his other person, they will provide the facilitation to the voters to locate his or her polling station number and the serial number in the electoral roll. One representation was made in the last elections to the other states that we should increase the height of voting compartment to ensure secrecy of voting. Because this time, besides the VU and CU, which is popularly known as EVM, we would also be having the VVPATs, that is the voter verifiable paper audit trail machine will also be there. So the height of the voting compartment, which was 24 inches earlier, has now been increased to 30%. And it will consist of a corrugated plastic sheet of flexboard of steel grey color, which is completely opaque, and it is also reusable, and it will be used for making the voting compartments. Coming to the all-women managed polling station, this is also a new innovation which has been done by Gujarat. And we had commission had suggested that at least now we should make a beginning that there should be polling station where we have 100% polling personnel of women, including the security. So in Gujarat elections, we will have 102 all-women managed polling station. That is one per constituency, where it will be manned entirely by the women polling officials. Next important issue is regarding electronic voting machines and the voter verifiable paper audit trail. As we had decided in the June 2017 meeting and also the meeting which we held with you in May 2017 in the Vigyan Bhavan, the polling in the state would be conducted at all the 50,128 polling stations using EVMs and also the VVPATs. Commission has already made arrangements to ensure that required number of EVMs and VVPATs are available in the state of Gujarat at all the polling stations. The first level check of EVMs and VVPAT is being done in the presence of the representatives of the political party. A two-stage randomization of EVMs and VVPATs will also be done. I would just like to share the experience because in this February-March 2017 election, Goa is a state where we had deployed 100% VVPATs in the Goa assembly election. The number of constituencies was 40 and total number of polling stations was 1,642. So we have now a good experience of deployment of VVPATs in all the polling stations. So, and not only that, all the by-elections which have been held to the parliamentary seats also and to the assembly seats also after June 2017, we have used VVPATs in all these by-polls also. One more decision which we have taken is that the slips which are generated in the VVPAT machine after the polling is completed and on the counting day, the slips of at least one polling station which will be selected randomly would also be counted. This is on a pilot basis we are starting, but I think it is a good beginning because people should also have that faith. The VVPAT has got the, what is VVPAT? A common man can see, main apni vote dekh sakunga. That is the basic purpose of this new machine which has been developed ingeniously and in our own in-house development. So this is very important that every voter shall be able to see after he presses the button of BU, there will be a flash of light where a slip of 10 centimeters into 5.6 centimeters will be there. He can see that there will be three things which will be displayed. The serial number of the candidate on the ballot paper, which is there on the BU, his name and also the symbol of the candidate would also be visible in this flash of light, which shall be for 7 seconds. The next point is regarding filing of affidavits. All the candidates who contest the elections have to file affidavits, and we have issued instructions that in the affidavit which are to be filed by all the candidates, it should be filled for all columns. If any column in the affidavit is left blank, the returning officer will issue a notice to the candidate to file the revised affidavit with all columns duly filled in. After such notice, if a candidate still fails to file affidavit complete in all respects, the nomination paper will be liable to be rejected by the returning officer at the time of scrutiny of the nominations. Another important aspect related to poll is the implementation of Model Code of Conduct. The Model Code of Conduct comes into effect immediately from now onwards. All provisions of the Model Code will apply to the whole state of Gujarat, and it will be applicable to all candidates, political parties, and the government of Gujarat. The Model Code of Conduct will also be applicable to the Union Government in so far as announcement or policy decisions relating to Gujarat state is concerned. The Commission has made elaborate arrangements for ensuring effective implementation of the MCC guidelines. Any violations of these guidelines would be dealt with by the Commission. And it will be applicable to all the stakeholders, that is the political parties, contesting candidates, their agents. The government of the poll-bound state has also been directed to ensure that no misuse of official machinery is done during the MCC period. Commission has also issued instructions for swift, effective and stringent action for enforcement of the Model Code during the first 72 hours of the announcement of the election schedule, and also maintaining extra vigilance and strict enforcement during the last 72 hours prior to the day of polling. These instructions have already been issued in the form of SOPs to all the concerned election official machinery at the district level and at the state level. There would also be videography and webcasting and CCTV coverage in which all critical events of the political and electioneering would be videographed. DOs will arrange sufficient number of video and digital cameras, and for this purpose, the events for videography will include filing of nomination papers, scrutiny, allotment of symbol, first level checking, that is FLC, preparation and storage of EVMs, important public meetings, processions during election campaign, process of dispatching of postal ballot papers. Additionally, CCTVs will be installed at important border checkpost and static checkpoints for the effective monitoring and surveillance. Commission has directed that webcasting, CCTV coverage, videography and digital cameras will also be deployed inside critical polling booths and polling stations in vulnerable area to closely monitor the proceedings on the polling day without violating the secrecy of the voting. Next aspect is law and order and the security arrangement and deployment of the forces. Conduct of elections involve elaborate security management, which includes not just the security of polling personnel, polling station, but also the overall security of the election process. CAPFs would be deployed to supplement the local police force in ensuring a peaceful and conducive atmosphere for smooth conduct of elections in a free, fair and credible manner. The CAPFs will be deployed well in advance for area domination, because people should also have an idea that the CAPF has been deployed. They will be having route marches in the vulnerable pockets, point patrolling and other confidence building measures to reassure and build faith in the minds of the voters, especially those belonging to the weaker sections, minorities, etc. The CAPF will also be deployed in expenditure-sensitive constituencies and other vulnerable areas and critical polling stations as per the assessment of ground realities by the CO of the state in consultation with the stakeholders. Entire force police deployment in assembly segments would be done under the oversight of the police observers, which will be posted by the Commission. Commission lays a special emphasis on the advance preventive measures to be taken by the DMs and the police authorities to maintain law and order and to create atmosphere conducive for conduct of free and fair elections. The Commission will also be monitoring the ground situation and will take appropriate action to ensure peaceful, free and fair elections throughout the state. Next aspect is of election expenditure monitoring. comprehensive instructions for the purpose of effective monitoring of the election expenditure of the candidates have been issued, which includes setting up of flying squad, static surveillance teams and video surveillance teams, in involvement of investigation directorates of the Income Tax Department, State Excise Department and the Police Authority have been asked to monitor production, distribution, sale, storage of liquor and intoxicants. In the case of Gujarat, no liquor is manufactured, but liquor can come from the neighboring states. So that is the point which the concerned excise department of the state would have to monitor closely. The functioning and operation of the flying squad will be closely monitored using the GPS tracking system, because all the vehicles of flying squads and SSTs would have GPS. For greater transparency and for ease of monitoring of election expenses, the candidates would be required to open a separate bank account and incur their election expenses from this particular bank account. The Investigation Directorate of Income Tax has been asked to open Air Intelligence Units, that is in short AIU, in all the ports of the state, and also to gather intelligence and take necessary action regarding movement of large sums of money. Next issue is regarding what is the ceiling of the election expenditure. As far as the ceiling of the candidate is concerned, all the MLAs who are contesting, all the candidates contesting for the seat of MLAs, the ceiling of expenditure is 28 lakhs per candidate in the state of Gujarat. And all the candidates are also required to furnish their expenditure within 13 days of the declaration of results with the DO. A final account have also to be submitted by the political parties. They are required to submit their expenditure for the elections within 75 days on completion of the elections. And such accounts are uploaded on the website of the commission for public view. Another important aspect is the media engagement. Commission has always considered media as an important ally and a potent force multiplier in ensuring an effective and efficient election management. Hence, the Commission has directed the CEO of Gujarat to take up regular interaction with the media during elections and maintaining an effective and positive line of communication with media. Strong and concerted focus on creation of effective information dissemination system to the media at the state and district level to ensure timely and due access of election data by appointment of a nodal officer has been put in place. Effective steps to sensitize the media about the implementation of the MCC has also been told to them. One issue on which there is a lot of discussion and concern also is the system of paid news. To deal with the menace of paid news, a mechanism has been laid out with three-tier media certification and media media certification and monitoring committees. In short, we call them MCMC, at the district level, state level and at the ECI level. Revised comprehensive instructions on paid news are now available on the Commission's website also, and necessary instructions have been issued to CEO of Gujarat to ensure briefing of political parties and the media in the districts about the paid news. Pre-certification of political advertisements is another important area. Bulk SMSs, voice messages on phone in election campaign will also be in the purview of the pre-certification of election advertisements, as in the case of all electronic media, TV channels, cable network and radio, including private FM channels, cinema halls, audio-visual displays in public places and political advertisement in social media. Another important field in which election authorities at the state level, district level and the taluka level have done a very good work is the sweep. Full form is Systematic Voters Education and Electoral Participation. Voter helpline, voters facilitation centers, web and SMS-based search facilities are active for helping the voters. Reminder services on poll days have also been planned. As per the direction of the Commission, booth awareness groups have also been activated at the polling station for motivating the voters and keeping them informed. Ambassadors have also been set up in all the educational institutions for facilitating electoral participation amongst the youth. This time we have also given one more focus area or core area is highlighting the use of VVPATs by the voters, because this is the new thing which the voters will be now seeing in the polling station, in the polling compartment. Till now they were using EVMs, that is the BU and the CU, ballot unit and the control unit. So how to have a look at the vote which is cast by them? That is why, you know, mobile vans have also been deployed. Commission would be deploying general observers which are coming from the other state. They are all IAS officers. The observers are also given a detailed training program also, and they will be keeping a close watch on every stage of electoral process to ensure free and fair election. Their names, addresses within the district constituency, and the telephone numbers would be given in the media of the local newspapers, so that general public can approach them for any grievance redressal. Besides the general observers, there will be police observers also. They would be all senior IPS officers who would be posted in the state, depending upon the need, sensitivity and assessment of the ground realities. They will also monitor all activities relating to the force deployment, law and order situation, and coordinate between the police administration and the CAPF, because CAPF it will also be deployed in the state, at in all the districts and in all the talukas. So coordination with the commandant of the CPF and also with the SP of the district, this role of coordination will also be undertaken by these police observers. The third category of observer is the expenditure observers. Commission has decided to appoint adequate number of expenditure observers and also assistant expenditure observers who will be monitoring the election expenditure of the contesting candidates. Control room and complaint monitoring centers with 24 hours toll-free numbers would be operative during the entire election process. Banks and financial intelligence units of the Government of India have been asked to forward suspicious cash withdrawals to the concerned election officials. IT has also been increasingly used in the last 2-3 years to facilitate the voting and the election management process. The first important IT initiative is Samadhan, that is the public grievance redressal and monitoring system. A comprehensive, robust and reliable public grievance redressal system has been developed by the Commission to provide a common platform for all complaints, grievances, concerns and suggestions which can be given by any members of the public, including the all stakeholders. A mobile app will also be made available for the common man so that they can submit complaints with photography and videos on this common platform. The second important IT application is Suvidha, that is the single window clearance. This is a very important IT application, because all the political parties and the contesting candidates will be able to have online permissions for permissions like, you know, holding of meetings, rallies, vehicles, temporary election officers, loudspeaker, and the you don't have to come to make an application. So the purpose of this IT application is that any person who wants to have a public meeting or a contesting candidate or the party, they can have online application. And it is, I would only like to clarify that it does not mean that those persons who give a application in physical form will be denied. The only advantage is that online application has the time of the receipt of the application, so it can be very useful to the concerned authorities. And all the permissions should be given in 24 hours. And where the permission is sought for a helipad or helicopter landing, there the time would be 36 hours, because safety norms are there, and they will, person who is seeking permission must comply with those safety norms also. The third IT important application is the Sugam, that is the vehicle management system. It is an IT-based vehicle management system with the facility of issuance of requisition letters for vehicles, requisitioning of the vehicles and bank details of the owner and driver, transfer of vehicles from one district to the other. And it will also facilitate the e-payment to the vehicle owners after the polling duties are completed. Next important aspect is webcasting and CCTV at polling stations. Webcasting would be undertaken at the identified critical polling station for live monitoring of the election process, to keep a check on the illegal activities such as booth capturing, money distribution, bogus voting, and to bring complete transparency in the voting process would be undertaken. During the election process, CCTV monitoring and webcasting will also be done at various border checkposts, check nakas, and sensitive and critical locations across the constituencies to keep a vigil on the any illegal activities which might be undertaken. Second one is polling personnel deployment system. This is another new IT application which will be used for creating database of polling and police personnel, generation of command, appointment letter, sending SMS, and regarding deputation, training, tagging of patrolling party with force, generation of application for postal ballots. The next point is regarding the conduct of the government officials. The commission expects all the officials working in the state to be following the conduct of elections to discharge their duties in an impartial manner without any fear or favor. They are deemed to be on deputation to the commission and will be subject to its control and supervision and the discipline. The conduct of all government officials who have been entrusted with election-related responsibilities and duties would remain under the scrutiny of the commission, and action would be taken against those officials who are found wanting on any account. Coming to the other aspect of poll day monitoring systems, a constant and stringent 24-hour monitoring of the critical events and activities of the poll day would be also undertaken by the monitoring system. All crucial events like reaching of the polling parties, votes cast, voters' images would be captured and monitored during the state-of-the-art IT application. All data captured offline is synchronized with the central servers as soon as the person using the app comes in the coverage area. Some of the new initiatives which we are taking in the Gujarat poll are use of VVPATs at all the polling stations. I have already shared with you that all the 50,128 polling stations would have VVPATs in all the 182 assembly constituencies, and we will be also using the security network, which would be used for preventing intimidation and inducement to voters, to maintain law and order in an effective manner, and to take swift and time-bound preventive action against the intimidators such as the bail jumpers, proclaimed offenders, history cheaters, antisocial elements. The license arm deposited issued by the DMs would have to be deposited with the concerned SHO of the police station. The illegal arms, liquor, drugs seized, NBWs would have to be got executed, and cash or freebies would be seized at the NAKAs and in the constituencies. Next important IT initiative is the RONet. To have efficient election management as per the Commission's direction, an integrated IT solution which works on the web portal, mobile app, and through SMS has been developed to be implemented the first time in the entire state of Gujarat, which would make the holding of election to be efficient, transparent, smooth. This innovation is based on pilot RONet, which was already implemented in few constituencies of Ludhiana district in Punjab during the February 2017 assembly elections. All women manage polling stations. There would be 182 polling stations where only women officials will be there for manning of the polling. Next IT initiative is the e-Atlas. As a new innovation, GIS-based planning, implementation, and monitoring of various election-related activities in real time is being implemented in the state of Gujarat. It would be useful for the election planning purposes. Next initiative is the e-payment gateways for goods and services. The commission has decided, and it has been told to the COs and the DOs, that all payments would now be made through e-payment gateway. Firstly, for the timely payment of all the civilian officials and the police officials deployed for election duties. Secondly, timely payment to the owners of the vehicles, whose vehicles were requisitioned for election purposes. And third is timely payment for all the vendors who provide goods and services for election-related duties in the assembly constituencies. The elections in Gujarat have always been peaceful in the past, and the commission will take all necessary measures to ensure peaceful elections in Gujarat. The commission is committed to maintain purity of elections and to deliver free, fair, and transparent elections. Commission has directed the state level and the district level election authorities to be fearless, unbiased, neutral and independent from any influence whatsoever. Conduct and discharge of duties by the election officials would be under the watch of commission. The commission is also making sincere efforts to ensure that no voter should be left behind in the forthcoming legislative assembly elections in Gujarat. Now, coming to the schedule for the election, there are total 182 seats in the assembly of Gujarat. The polling would be conducted in two phases. The phase one would consist of 89 assembly constituencies covering 19 districts out of the total 33 districts of the Gujarat state. The date of issue of a gazette notification for the first phase would be 14th November 2017, that is Tuesday. Last day of nominations date would be 21st November 2017, that is also Tuesday. Third is the date of scrutiny of the nominations will be 22nd November. And last date for withdrawal of candidature would be 24th November, that is Friday. The date of polling would be 9th December 2017, which would be Saturday. As far as the second phase of assembly is concerned, it will consist of 93 assembly constituencies and there will be 14 districts. The date of gazette notification would be 20th November 17. Last date of nominations would be 27th November 17, that is also Monday. Date of scrutiny of nominations would be 28th November 17. Last date for withdrawal of candidature would be 30th November, that would be Thursday. And date of polling would be 14th December 17, which would be Thursday. The counting of votes for both the date of polling would be 14th December 2017, Thursday. 9th December for first phase and 14th December for second phase. Date of counting will be 18th December for both the phases. 18th December, that is Monday. Both the phases. For the 182 seats, it will be on 18th December. Now coming to just to share with you, the phase 1 would consist of 89 assemblies. It will cover 19 districts. I will only read the name of the district, that is Kutch district with six seats, Surendranagar district with 5 seats, Morbi 3 constituent ACs, Rajkot would be 8, Jamnagar 5 constituents, 5 ACs. Amreli would be 5 seats, Bhavnagar district 7, Bota 2 seats, Narmada district 2 seats, Bharuch district 5 seats, Surat 16 seats, Tapi would be 2 seats, Dang district 1, Navsari district 4, Valsad district would be 5. So out of 33 districts, 19 districts would be covered in the first phase. 19 districts with 89 seats. And as far as the phase 2 is concerned, the total districts covered would be 14. Ahmedabad 21 seats, Banaskantha 9 seats, Patan 4 seats, Mehsana 7 seats, Sabarkantha 4, Aravali district 3, Gandhinagar 5, Anand district 7, Kheda 6, Mahisagar district 3, Panchmahal 5, Dahod district 6.